Okay, so there's a little bit of the original service left right in the middle right there. I think I can get it with some more indirect percussion from this edge here, so that's what I'm going to do. Okay, so I just need to clean up some of those steps. And I'm going to thin down this base right here and then clean up the edges and then notch it. Well, I might notch it first and then clean up the edges after. I can probably pick those out with a really sharp steel tool, but I'd rather pop those out with some flakes. Okay, I'll stop messing with that side. There's still a slight bend to it. I might be able to remove some mass from the tip here, but I'll wait till later. Well, yeah, I'll wait till a little bit later. Now, I think this is part of the original surface on this side here. So I can remove that with pressure. Okay, right now the base is still a little thick for notching, so I'm going to run some more flakes. Well, that's not too much better, but I'm being super cautious not to break it, so I'll go ahead and notch it. I'm trying to find the best way to show this. Sorry about that. That notch is deep enough. What I'm trying to do is eliminate that little crushing area at the base of the notch. Try to eliminate as much of that white powdery look as possible. I might not be able to, but that's good enough. I'm just expanding the bottom of that notch. It just looks kind of cool that the bottom of the notches are expanded. That's good enough. If I mess with it too much more, I'm gonna knock off these little corners here. I could come in and work the notches from this angle here, but I don't have much success with that because a lot of times my notcher will go through the notch and stick in there, and then when I try to take it out, it'll pop off one of the corners or one of the ears. So that's good enough. I'm just going to dress up the edge now. It's already 31 minutes. It's putting in a little bit of a concavity. It also gives me an opportunity to thin any areas that are thick down here. I'm not going to abrade for this one because I want it to remain sharp. I'm not going to abrade before this pass. I'm being extra careful not to create crushing or put too much pressure on the point. I'm going to switch over to steel. Just a lot of little serrations in it right now. I don't want those on there. I want a clean, relatively flat edge. So I'm going to use the wider steel pressure flaking tool. Okay, so that's good enough. I didn't thin down the tip. I didn't want to risk it. So it stayed pretty much the same thickness. I just reduced the width to get rid of some of that stepping I had along the edge. Now this one's longer and more narrow than the other one. So a little step in here. I'm not gonna worry about it. I wish I had a lighter background. Still a little bit of a curve in it. But I could take that curve out by losing some length off the tip and then thinning the tip down. But it's good enough. That's it.